I'm Dr. Jyotsna Patel, practicing gynecologist and obstetrician at Umang Hospital, Andheri East, and Krupa Hospital, Andheri West, Warsowa. Today I'll be talking on a topic of vaginal infection. Now, vaginal infection is seen in all age groups, more commonly in reproductive age group. The cause of vaginal infection is most common is fungal infection. It can also be mixed infection as well as bacterial infection. Now, how do you come to know that there is vaginal infection? We have clinical signs and symptoms of vaginal infection. Whenever there is a discharge from vagina, which is giving you a lot of itching and foul smell, you can guess that it's vaginal infection. You need to go to a gynecologist to examine, get yourself examined. We do clinical examination where we check what kind of discharge it is, whether it is foul smelling or no. Also, sometimes we do vaginal swabbing if it is coming recurrently. And that is how we diagnose that it's vaginal infection. Now, there are also lot of misconceptions about vaginal discharge. Like a normal vaginal discharge is a sticky discharge. It's a white color discharge. It's a transparent discharge. So a white color discharge, which is sticky and transparent, non-foul smelling, is a normal vaginal discharge. So that should not be mixed up with a vaginal infection. A vaginal infection will always give you a lot of symptoms of itching and foul smelling. Now, once we have diagnosed that there is a vaginal infection, clinically we get an idea as to whether it is a candidial infection, that is a fungal infection, or whether it's a mixed kind of infection. We go about treating vaginal infection. Now, treatment of vaginal infection usually involves giving you antifungal vaginal pessaries, antifungal vaginal ointment to be applied, and sometimes even oral antifungal tablets. That is as far as the candidiasis is concerned or the fungal infection is concerned. When it is a mixed kind of an infection, we also add an antibacterial agent to it, mostly clindamycin. The pessaries, usually we ask patients to put it in the night in the vagina along with that application of the ointment, and taking oral tablets usually in the morning as well as in the evening. So when we are treating vaginal infection, we must not forget treating the partner, because vaginal infection is also sexually transmitted. So when we treat the patient by giving antifungal vaginal pessaries and ointments, we also ask them to avoid sexual intercourse for the course of treatment, and even we treat the partner by giving antifungal local ointment to be applied. Sometimes even oral antifungal tablets to the partner. Now, when it is in the reproductive age group, usually this is what we follow. But sometimes when the patient is, say, above 40 years old, we also ask the patient to check their blood sugar levels somewhere, say, around more than 35 years. Okay, so when the patient is more than 35 years, we ask them to get their sugar levels checked, because repeated vaginal infections can be an indication of patient developing diabetes. So this is about the treatment part. Now, can we talk of prevention? How do we prevent vaginal infection? Yes. As we know, the cause, most common cause is fungus. Now, fungus grows whenever there is a lot of moisture collection there. And moisture usually happens in the vagina during periods when you are having your menstrual cycle and there's blood flow and you're wearing sanitary pads or tampons. That is the time a lot of moisture gets collected. And that is why it is most commonly seen post-menstrual. So it can be prevented by using cotton pads, by using cotton panties, and changing your pads as often as possible, because that will not allow the moisture to collect there and will prevent fungal infection. Also, if you suspect that your partner is having some kind of symptoms of infection, you must get him treated. So this is all about vaginal infection. If you want to know more information, please connect me on Lybrate.com.